Hello and welcome to Vision Academy. My name is Hanumant Ladva, and in this video we are going to write a C program to sort the given n names. Let us write the preprocessor directives hash include in Angular brace. We'll write standard input output dot h header file. The next preprocessor directive is hash include console input output dot h, and one more preprocessor directive we are going to write, that is string dot h, because we are going to use some of the built-in functions of string. So that's the reason we have to include this particular header file. Now we'll write void main function curly open brace, and here we are going to declare all the necessary variable which are to be used in the program. Here I'll write char, that is char type of data, and I'll write name, that is two dimensional array. In a square bracket I'm going to write the size of row as 20 and the size of column as 10. So two subscript represent two dimensional array. Next I'll take one more temporary array of one dimension whose size is 10. Now let us declare some other variable of type integer, such as I, j, both of these two are subscript, n represent the number of names. Let us write clr scr function which is used to clear the screen. Now we will ask the user how many names he wants to enter. So printf statement, in this, in a double quotation mark, I'm going to write how many names question mark and end the double quotation mark and put semicolon. Now we are going to receive the response from the user through keyboard using scanf statement. Here I'm going to write percentage %d, end the double quotation mark, ampersand of, we are going to use this n variable and semicolon. Now we are going to show the information to the end user using printf statement, like enter percentage %d names and backward slash n, and then I'll put comma n. So here it is going to print, for example, if I have entered three names, then it is going to print enter three names, because this percentage %d is associated with value stored in n. So whatever the user has entered the value over here, so same number will be printed here. Now let us take for loop. For I is equal to 0, I is less than n, and I plus plus. Now we are going to receive each name through iteration using scanf statement. Here in a double quotation mark I'm going to write the format specifier percentage %s, that indicates it's a string, comma name, and here I'm going to use the variable index index I and put semicolon. Now let us take looping structure. For I is equal to 0, I is less than n, I plus plus, curly open brace, will take one more for loop, j is equal to I plus 1, j is less than n, and j plus plus. Now curly open brace, next we are going to check the condition if, we'll use strcmpi, that is string comparison case insensitive. Here we will take the name of the variable, that is array. Here I'm going to write name of I, comma name of j is greater than 0. If first name is greater than the second name, then the swapping has to take place, means interchange of the string must take place. Here I'm going to use curly open brace and one more inbuilt function of string, that is strcpy, that is string copy. So next I'm going to use here the temporary variable which we have already declared here as temporary array. So this one we are going to use, we'll put comma, and the next argument in this function is name of I. Means what? Here the first name is copied to temporary variable. Next strcpy, and here I'm going to write name of I, comma, name of J in a square bracket and put a round bracket, put semicolon. Now one more statement, strcpy. Here the second name is copied to first name. Next we'll write name of J, comma, temp. So what exactly we are doing is we are swapping or interchanging the strings once this condition is true. Let us put curly closing brace for this respective opening brace of if and closing brace for this for and closing brace for this outer for loop. So I'm going to put one more closing brace over here. Next we need to print the sorted array. So printf sorted names r backward slash n, end the double quotation mark and put semicolon, for I is equal to 0, I is less than n, I plus plus. Next we'll write printf statement. Here I need to print all the sorted names. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to use format specifier percentage s backward slash n so that each and every sorted name come one below the other. So here I'm going to end the double quotation mark, put comma, and now I'm going to write name of I and semicolon. Here I'll write get ch function and then curly closing brace. Now let us see how exactly this program works. Here I'm going to write output. Once we compile and run this program, it will ask the user to enter how many names. For example, I'm going to enter 3. So here n value becomes 3. Enter percentage d n names. Here it is going to ask the user to enter n is holding 3. Enter 3 names. Now we are going to iterate through and we are going to insert 3 names using the scanf statement. Now let us enter, for example, I am going to enter Radha, I'll write Gopal, and the third name is, I'll write Krishna. So observe that we have written capital R, capital G and capital K over here. So if I write lowercase letter A, lowercase letter G and lowercase letter K, then the value of these ASCII values will get changed. Okay, yes. Now let us enter into the actual logic, how exactly the swapping takes place and how exactly all of these will get sorted out. Now for I is equal to 0, so whenever we enter the names, so it is going to form, here you can see we have got 20 10. What is the meaning of this? So here first 20 represent 20 rows and 10 columns. So I'm not going to draw 20 rows and 10 columns here. Just for the sake of these three names, I'm going to write the two dimensional array. So how exactly it is going to map in a memory? So I'll write RADHA. So that is first row, second row Gopal, GOPAL, and the next one is KRISHNA. Now all the three names are entered and now we are going to map this one in a memory something like this. Okay, so index number starts from 0, 1, 2 and here also it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. Now you can see here we have taken I is equal to 0 and J is equal to I plus 1. For the first time I is 0, here J will become 0 plus 1 is 1. So here I is pointing to 0 and now J is pointing to 1 just because of this equation. So here you can see I is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 is initialized to J. So here J is pointing to 1. Now we are going to compare both of these two strings letter by letter. But right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to compare only the first letter. Okay, yes. Suppose I take one more name with like lower case letter Krishna. If I write lower case letter K and Krishna, then it has to check this capital K with a lower case letter K. So lower case letter K has got higher ASCII value than uppercase letter K. So hence iteration may not takes place. That is, iteration means swapping may not takes place. Here strcmp means it is string comparison case insensitive. Even if you write lowercase letter or uppercase letter, here if I write even lowercase letter K R I S H A N A, then it is not going to swap. So here this particular function will treat both Krishna as same. Yes. Next, here you can see strcmpi name of I. So that is first name, and next name of J, that is second name. If first name is greater than second name, greater than zero means what? If first name Radha is greater than second name, then the swapping must takes place. Here you can see here R is greater than G as per alphabet. If I start writing alphabet, first G will come, then R will come. So hence this is true. What will happen now? Swapping takes place. Swapping takes place means what? We'll start copying the first name Radha to temporary variable, and we are going to copy the second name Gopal to the first row, that is name of I, that is I is zero. So first name, so this Gopal will be copied to the first row. Next, temporary is holding what? Radha. So Radha is copied to J. So Radha will come onto the second row. Correct? Yes. Now we'll write Gopal first and Radha next. Okay. So again, control transfers to inner for loop by incrementing the value of J by 1. Now it will be earlier it was 1. Now it is pointing to 2. And I is equal to 0 only. Now J is pointing to 2. So it is going to compare the first name with the last name. So what is the first name now? Now first name is Gopal. Correct? So next name, last name was Krishna. So this and this one will be compared. Here G will come first, and after that K will come. Correct? So that's the reason this condition fails. So all these three statements will not get executed. Again, control transfers to inner for loop by incrementing the value of J by 1. J will become 3. So 3 is less than 3. No, condition fails. Once the condition fails, then the control goes to outer for loop by incrementing the value of I by 1. Now I is going to point to 1. Now I is going to point to index number 1. So J is going to point 1 plus 1, because I value is 1, 1 plus 1, it is 2. Now it is pointing to 2. Now we are going to compare both of these two strings here actually. So this is I and this is J. So this is index number 1, index number 2, and this one is 0. Now I is pointing to 1, J is pointing to 2. Now we are going to compare both of these two. strcmpi name of I. Name of I is what? Name of I is 1. Correct? So name of 1 consisting of Radha, and name of J, that is 2, consisting of Krishna. So here you can see R is having higher ASCII value than K, because R comes after K. Hence it is true. If this is true, then the swapping takes place. So here Gopal will be intact as it is, and Krishna will come in place of Radha, and Radha will come in place of Krishna here. Yes. So again, control transfers to the inner for loop. Here it will become 3. So now again it fails. It is false. Again, control transfers to outer for loop by incrementing the value of I by 1. Now it is going to point to 2. Correct? So that is Radha. So here I is going to point to 2. And here J is pointing to what? 2 plus 1. It will become 3. 3 is less than 3. No, condition fails. Again, control transfers to outer for loop by incrementing the value of I by 1. Now I will become 3. 3 is less than 3? No, condition fails. Once the condition fails, control comes out of the looping structure and it is going to print the next statement. So next statement consisting of what? Here it consisting of sorted names are. Just because of this backward slashing, cursor come down to the next line, and this using for loop we are going to iterate through all these three names. So here it is going to print just because of this percentage is format specifier and it is associated with name of I. So first name it is going to print as Gopal, and next one is Krishna, and the third one is Radha. Let us execute this program and check out how exactly this works. For that, I will take you to my laptop screen.
Here you can see that I have already written this program in Turbo C++ integrated development environment to save your time. Now we are going to compile this program by pressing Alt F9. Here you can see it is showing success, means there is no syntax error. And now I'm going to press Enter. Let us execute this program by pressing Control F9. Here you can see it is asking how many names. Now I'm going to enter 3, and now it is asking the user to enter 3 names. Now let us write, I'll write here R-A-D-H-A, Radha, and then the second name I'm going to enter is Gopal, and the third name that I'm going to enter is Krishna, and then I'm going to press enter. Here you can see the sorted names are Gopal, Krishna and Radha. I hope you understood this program. If so, please write in the comment box as understood. Thank you.